big pimpin', baby.
What is up, guys? Swallow J here. I'm here with my co-host.
Heart of War.
Yeah.
Joe Rogan.
Name it, dude.
So it's true. Well,
was it Joe Rogan?
I don't know. He doesn't post a lot of memes just because he doesn't like having to go back and, you know, try to find the credit. He's weird about that. He spoke about that because he doesn't know where it originally came from, and he's a big proponent of, you know, whoever originally did it.
Thanks. Hey, guys, you might know what I just saw today.
You fucked it up for everybody. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
You know what I just saw today, guys?
What did you see?
Star Wars.
Spoiler alert! This is where you guys tune off because we're about to spoil it.
Please do
listen,
not.
Man. So Rey's dad is...
Seriously, don't do
pregnant.
This.
Pregnant.
No.
Luke Skywalker is...
Don't do this. I like
a
you.
A girl.
I like you too much.
Yoda is...
Chewbacca is...
Oh, yeah.
Yoda's
by the
dad.
Way,
hey, Yoda, Yoda's not even in this. Yo, motherfucker. Chris. He died like fucking long time ago, bro.
Hold on. Han Solo is actually...
Dead.
Actually.
Luke. Dead.
Transgender.
Actually. Dead.
PC. Actually. He's Jedi X.
Jedi X.
Yo, real Linux. Quick. Chris, I looked up. Mr. Rogers never served in the military.
Okay.
That was a lie.
So how much do you need to watch the previous movies to understand this one?
Well, listen, you should watch them all just so you know what's going on because the story is pretty deep.
How long is it
going
to take me to watch them all?
Oh, man. See, what, 2 hours each?
So you've never seen any of them?
Yeah, well, that's great. You got
I'll tell you what, you got homework.
Week. Yeah, week.
You and Pat need this. To get together week and watch back. All of them.
Yeah, Sarsinski, he hasn't seen it either, huh?
He was kind of confused as to why, and they told me it's just a classic at this point for you, sir. It's like Scarface. You had to have seen Scarface, The Godfather, Rocky.
Well, if I get sick anytime soon, I'll just marathon it. And
I got you.
Oh. Give her the AIDS.
Wait a
I'll
minute.
Just go hug my kid and.
Kids are always sick, huh?
He's sick. My kids never get sick. My son's sick right now.
I have a friend at work, and like she's always saying, like, "Yeah, my son's sick. My daughter's sick." I'm like, "God damn, they're always sick." They're like, they just give it back and forth to each other.
They do.
It's school, bro.
It's it horrible. Really is,
yeah. My daughter's been bleach bombing the house like all morning.
It's just literally a petri dish of just germs.
When I made it to boot camp, man, I remember getting really sick. Everybody had they call it the Ricky crud, man. The recruit crud. You just sick.
See, I've heard people say you always get sick there, right?
Camp, yeah.
So bad.
Because like they have people from all over the country and even other parts of the world all in one room.
It's not like you can exactly like wash your hands all the time or use sanitizer all like.
And you're all up each other's shit the whole time too. It's like, fuck, man. Terrible, man. Just terrible.
No, it was the worst whenever. It's always the worst like when you start them in preschool or like kindergarten. That year is just a year of just sickness.
I think elementary has always been the worst. My kids have been all right, though. High school and middle school, but yeah.
Yeah, it's gotten better since, you know, Tegan's in middle, so that's kind of tapered off. But and Tyler, since I guess maybe just because he's gotten older and his immune system's gotten built up better over time, it's not so bad. But, man, the first couple of years, it's like legit once a month he's sick. Something
Dude,
either, just
you
a
know,
cough.
Quick parenting tip from Miggy. If you don't want your kid to get sick, give him HGH.
Really?
It'll work.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where can I get that?
Keep them in the cold.
I don't know. I read that on bodybuilding.com, so it has to be true.
Totally going
to
take parenting tips from that website.
Yeah, let's take parenting advice from a guy who doesn't have kids. That'll be great.
Listen, man, you don't have to be a helicopter pilot to know that a helicopter tree is fucked
up. How did I know that
was
going to come up?
Totally stole that from the comedian. You don't have to be like a race car driver to know that when the car crashes in the wall that they fuck up.
Something went wrong.
Duh. Should have hit the brakes. Just like all you parents.
I did learn
should have pulled out.
Protection.
I did learn some tips last night from Wallow on how to deal with children.
Oh, God.
Hey.
That was hilarious.
Guys.
I like the way he calls them.
Listen. Never take advice from me.
Hey.
Ever.
It was hilarious. He's like, hey, what's this thing's name? What do you call these things?
I believe he's called a child.
It was funny.
It was.
Sorry, guys.
She was a sweetheart, though. I liked her.
She was.
I got my hug. I got my little kiss on the cheek.
She was easy to deal with, man. I don't know why he had such a hard time. He's like, I don't know how to talk to kids. I was like, well, you're the same height as him. Well, shit.
Well, Bert,
ah, fuck you!
Bert's almost, Bert was almost the same way. Like, he didn't quite know. Like,
yeah,
he didn't quite know what to do with it.
It was like, funny. Yeah, Bert was like, oh, man. Because she would just,
she would go between his legs. She would love to
climb on Bert and do, like, dips on his knees. And he's like, oh.
When we were leaving, she goes, give me a kiss. And he's like, I gotta go.
Yeah. Like, he tried to move her one time, so he just palmed her head like a basketball and just tried to, like, move her to the side.
What give me a little kiddo and guide him along there. Yeah.
It's a kid, bro. It's okay.
That's Bert's weakness, his kids.
Yeah, right.
Walla just has his dog. He's like,
yeah. Yeah.
So I was thinking, guys, if we were to have lightsabers, what color lightsaber would you have?
Pink.
You'd have a pink one? That makes sense.
No, you can't do that.
You can't have pink.
That's against canon.
Yeah.
I don't care.
The only person that's been able to break canon was
Windu.
Windu Mace.
I'm a ginger. I get what I want.
No, you don't.
I want to be like Samuel L. Jackson, have a purple one.
That he's the only one. Like I said, he's the only one that's been able to break canon.
Yep.
And have a purple. They're either red, green, or blues. Or black if they're a dark saber.
I'll take
black.
There's a white one too.
Those are gray Jedi's.
It's kind of cold.
So they're kind of, they've never been, a white one's never been in a movie.
Can I have a disco one?
No.
Oh, could you imagine that?
I'll have the rainbow one. Thank you.
I want the one with the two flags. So I think, flags.
I think the green one is like a guardian one, right? Or is it like green? What's the blue one?
Let's look them up.
Pussy boy.
Cold, heartless.
I want the black one.
I want the big black one.
So there's no yellow one?
Yellow? Yeah, there has been yellow.
What about orange?
Let's see. Here is a full list.
Shit. It's a full list.
Oh, okay. That's going to be...
Have you guys seen the video?
Oh my God, there's 100 different...
Yeah, they used Owen Wilson to do the lightsaber noise, like they edited from clips before. Yeah. And it's just, wow.
That's great. Okay, I'm sorry. So yeah, there is around, looks to be around 30, 40 different colors.
So I get pink.
Wow.
It's all mainly blues, acid, amber.
Acid what?
I want acid reflux.
What?
Clear. So you got some cobalt, some green, some red, some oranges.
What's a cobalt?
Can I get cerulean?
Cobalt. That was Sanisi Ten's lightsaber.
Is it gray? What is it? What is cobalt?
Cobalt's a blue.
Oh.
I thought, no. What is cobalt?
Cobalt blue.
I thought it was a tool brain. I thought
there was a cobalt blue.
It's tool brain.
Yeah, I thought cobalt was like more of a shade of blue.
Look, be honest.
But then what's crazy is what's the picture that he's got a green one. So, yeah.
Take honestly, that I want to have a double-ended one. I want it to be green and yellow like John Deere.
Good call. That's what if I'm you don't off. Do Copenhagen.
Well, you could do like the, what's it, Darth Maul? You know, he had the double-ended one. Saying. One green and
one yellow for John Deere.
Yeah. Violets, so purples.
You get blue and red for Dixie.
Yeah.
Shit.
I'll go orange and blue for the Gators. Go Gators.
Man, I want it green like my can of Copenhagen.
Oh, that was funny.
If you don't chew Copenhagen, fuck you.
What, so crazy.
What about you, Callahan? White Walker?
Oh, I'd stick to just straight canon.
He wants three colors, man. He wants red, blue. Wine, blue for America.
I'm all blue.
Red, wine, blue.
America.
Yeah, so let's see. Significance of color.
And then his saber hand.
Bro, are you really digging that deep right now?
He is, bro. Remember, I just nerded him out real quick.
Yeah, he did.
I just turned him nerd.
Look, he's fact-checking. All right, so Star Wars.
Blue indicated a Jedi guardian. Jedi used the Force more on physical level. Green indicated a Jedi counselor. Reflect on the mysteries of the Force and fight the dark side at its heart. Yellow indicated a sentinel. So there's a Jedi who's honed his or her fighting skills in a balance of combat and scholarly pursuits.
So you're just like a guard sentinel.
I think you're more of a you're kind of middle of the road. You're a Force user, but you're also really good with the blade.
My man, so he's ready to debate this with you.
No, if we want to do that, we'd have to get Chris.
Get Chris back on here.
Yeah, get Alexander back on, and then we could just geek the fuck out.
Well, I'll tell you what. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go live and see that we're talking about Star Wars and watch the geeks, you know, possibly call.
Hold on. Let me know when you go live with it so I can make a comment to trigger some people.
What?
Oh, God.
Oh, here we go. What are you planning on saying?
I was going to say something, and if people listen to it, they'll get triggered and call in.
We'll just start tagging the dudes that we know will want to talk to it.
Yeah.
You know.
Let me see what I can do here. All right. Live.
Let me just wait for it to go red. You know, Sherry, that's the color.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. Time I don't talk, right?
Yeah. That's when you
red means no.
Yes, correct.
Oh, so that's how they got the different ones. They would just mix the crystals so that way they can get a different color.
Get the Kyber crystals.
Yeah.
Jedi, Kyber crystal, unite. I don't know. It's mixed two things.
I was just going to say that.
I just blew nerds' minds everywhere.
All right. So, you know, you get into a Star Destroyer and go to warp speed.
Sometimes I like to do things. I like to live dangerously.
You know, my favorite quote from Star Wars is "To infinity and beyond."
Yeah, that one, that one's out there.
I play with toys too.
What was it? Toys in the attic.
Toy
what?
Story.
I know.
See, I'm more of a fan of ludicrous speed.
Ludicrous?
Yeah,
ludicrous. We're a fan of ludicrous. Yeah, I love Rollout.
And we're live. Hold on. Yeah, give me, give me sorry, one guys, moment. Can't talk
now. Because I'm still thinking Spaceballs was better than Star Wars.
It was. I love
Spaceballs. It's funny. Oh, I see your Schwartz is as big as mine.
Yeah.
What was the name of the actor that played in Spaceballs?
John Candy?
The guy that played the Darth Vader type in Spaceballs?
Oh, that's Rick Moranis.
Yeah, Dude, I had a video pop up of why he's like no longer...
Yeah, he gave up. His wife died. He gave up and took care of his kids.
And I was like, fuck.
The funny thing is there's been a couple rumors I've seen that, you know, his kids have grown up. They've moved on. They're adults now. So he's actually, Mel Brooks has actually approached him to come back and do...
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids 12.
No, actually do Spaceballs 2,
yeah.
The Pursuit of Money, like they talked about in the original Spaceballs. So actually doing the sequel, which would be cool as shit.
So we're live. So go ahead and make the comment that you wanted to make.
All right. Yeah. So hell yeah. So my favorite Jedi is Spock.
Oh jeez.
Is that that's all easy. You said that on Friday.
That's so I know, easy.
But you built that up like you were going to say something.
Well, yesterday actually.
That's like saying my favorite Star Wars ship is the Enterprise. I mean, come on.
That's my favorite Star Wars ship.
I like Woody.
I'm sure you.
Okay, good to know.
I mean, I'm not surprised by the jury.
Not really.
Oh my god.
Oh, Mickey's like, what? Shit.
He started it.
Man, he did. Out.
Mickey's like, check, please.
Out of the whole series.
Well, now, was the movie good? Because I've heard mixed reviews. It seems like the user ratings are going way down.
Did you hear that, or did you read that on Rotten Tomatoes?
I did read that. Well, I've read that it's down to like 57 on Rotten Tomatoes. The original
57. It was 93 yesterday.
Yeah, yeah. And that's what kind of worries me. I'm wondering what's
here's
going on.
The thing. It's
is
the
it Star Wars?
A bunch of people that were mad that they couldn't go see it started rating it.
Well,
bad.
It could be, but I mean,
it's
is it Star Wars?
It's a never-ending battle between good against evil, and it's a cycle. So you kind of seen this movie already.
Listen.
Well, that was the same thing for the new one.
Yes and no.
Okay.
There's like some twisty shit in there.
Well, that's
there
good.
Is.
There's that's some good. Twisty shit. There's some twisty shit. Like Ray's father is.
Don't do that, please.
Okay.
Chewbacca.
No, that would be fucked up.
You know,
Han Solo still is
dead. Gay.
No, dead.
Okay. Is he gay?
I don't know.
You know what's one thing to appreciate about the movie though?
What?
It's not like Battlefront. You don't have to pay to have a good time.
Oh, so you're gonna go with the microtransaction
pay to win.
Pay to win scheme.
Yep.
You know, they have gotten just dog shitted.
They're
on.
Smart. They did that shit before net neutrality, so people will get ready for it.
Well, the problem is, man, is it's scaring me because one of the games that I was really looking forward to next year, Anthem, is being put out by EA. And I'm like, fuck, this is not good because if I'm hoping maybe this backlash from all of this is going to help maybe curb that where it doesn't happen. But well, if it's still in Anthem, I'm just going to skip. Be like, yeah,
well,
no,
you know,
I'm good.
You know what my theory with EA is? A lot of their, like, good series of games are, like, yearly release, like the sports franchises.
Yeah, yeah.
To me, that's fucking stupid in this day and age.
Well, they've made so much money on microtransactions through Madden and FIFA.
Yeah.
Well, here's the thing. That's different. But you can still make the same amount of money every year. Well, maybe not the same amount, but you're also spending more by putting a new disc out. You just call it Madden.
Update
and then the rosters. And be done with it.
Yeah, but they add new features
barely.
Or they do things
dude,
like that.
Barely. You don't think that you could do a software update?
Yeah, dude, that's what, at this day and age, they just have to do DLC.
You could, but the thing, I don't know. I mean,
because
they've made billions on microtransactions.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
But that's different, though, with those games compared to something like Battlefront. You know, you're going to pay some stupid little tokens to unlock O.J. Simpson before he went to jail
yeah.
in the game. That's cool and all, I guess, if you're into football, but I'm not going to pay fucking $20 just to unlock like Luke Skywalker.
Well, the thing is they what's really screwed them over is, you know, because I have no problem with loot boxes and stuff like that. Like I play Overwatch. It does great. It does a great loot box because everything is cosmetic. It has absolutely zero impact on gameplay.
I mean,
zero.
Call of Duty does it too. It's the same exact thing. Mm-hmm. You know, and it's like before, I know, speaking of EA, the Battlefield series, they did it eventually where you could just buy everything so you don't have to play the game.
They did that with it started in 3.
So it's like, you're like, hey, do you want to play this game to unlock the show? You want to just pay more money and be like, fuck it, dude.
You just want to pay more money. You're at level 50 and you've got all the weapon unlocked. But
hashtag money hunting.
Which, you know, that's fine. They did that kind of at a time, though, when that Battlefield game had been out for almost a year and a half.
Yeah.
So that made sense because World of Warcraft, they do that now. They make it to where now you can just create a character at max level.
What the hell is that? Sorry, that was my bus.
Okay. Normally I'm the one that screws up.
I know.
Hey-o.
My bad. Anyway, continue.
My bad. But, you can buy a level 80 or whatever the level cap is now. What? Because that game's been out 15 years. So they kind of expect you. The thing is everybody wants to go to in-game content. So to get to in-game content, you got to be max level to even start dipping into it. That's the problem, you know, like with Destiny. You know, there's a lot of just monotony just getting to end level. Because then you get to end level, then it's like, okay, now the game starts. Now you start really grinding and doing the raids and shit like that. And art doesn't
I hate the grind in Destiny. That's why I stopped.
Did you really?
Oh, yeah.
Did you play Destiny?
Dude, I had that game for a week.
Dude, I played it like religiously over and over and over and over again. Went on little raids and stuff. Just the grind of trying to get your weapons and armor and everything else made and up. It was ridiculous.
Well, I hate to tell you this, man. That grind is nothing to what it used to be like back in like WoW days and shit. Because I played WoW.
WoW for like a whole week. I said, fuck this. I'm not going out there just try to.
Dude,
this is a fetching session.
So, you know, I
that's why Skyrim is so much better. There's so much more things you could do.
Oh, yeah.
So much easier to do. Like,
I have a hard time in Skyrim because there is so much to do. I've never beaten Skyrim.
Chris is like, whoa, this isn't like World of War.
No, that's crazy. I've never beaten Skyrim, but I've played Skyrim for 4 years now.
But it's fun as hell.
But now I'm a top level at this and I'm a top level at that, but I've probably completed like maybe 4 missions of the main story.
Well, I've completed all those missions, but this is the thing, man. Skyrim, like, it keeps coming out with new additions or add-ons and stuff like that. So you can continue to play more missions and create your character
better. Well, you know, their engine was built by that because there is actually no way to ever run out of missions in Skyrim.
Yeah, exactly. Plus,
they will always randomize one
decision,
new missions.
Yeah, one decision will affect something later on. That,
yeah, I mean, there's some key things that happen, but just overall, there will always be missions somewhere for you to do. Doing something.
Yeah, man, dude, like, for me, with the whole WoW thing, I started playing WoW when Cataclysm came out.
Okay.
And I spent a lot of money to play this fucking game, and then I was like, god damn it, I spent money and I fucking hate this.
Yeah, I hated the game, too. They're like, oh, my tune does this, and then I'm like, your tune.
I played WoW when it came out at vanilla. I played it for a year and a half. I played it to the point to where it actually started becoming a problem.
Is that like a third-person kind of game?
It's an MMO.
Multi. Okay, do you see the actual character
Yeah.
Hands?
It's over the shoulder.
It's third person.
It's third person. You're talking about first person when you just see the hands.
Yeah, okay. But
in Skyrim, you can jump between the two.
Yep.
You hit a button.
Every angle helps out in Skyrim, which is
good. I get motion sickness, so I can't play those games. Like, I'll get
You can't play first person shooters?
World of Warcraft's the game for you then, my friend.
Nah, man. I get motion sickness.
It's so lame. And like the battle, the way that, like, I hate the combat is horrible.
Dude, I legit played it for a year and a half. I was part of a huge guild on Laughing Skull. We had like server firsts on boss kills and raids and things like that. But like I said, it got to the point to where it was actually becoming an issue because I would come home. This was before we had kids and all like that. I would come home. I would turn it on. I'd log in. I'd go take a shower. Because, you know, there was a queue back in those days, so you kind of have to wait a little bit to get in. I'd get in. I would eat dinner sitting in front of the PC while I'm playing, and I would play until 11, 12, 1 o'clock at night. And I did that every single
Why am I thinking of that South Park episode right now?
Dude, legit, it was.
I'm surprised you're still married.
You had, like, Cheetos.
Well, that was the thing. It started getting to the point to where, you know, and then we had our first kid, and Amanda was kind of like, yo, this shit's really cutting into – you know, family. And I was like, you know what? You are right. I'm out. And yeah. then I came back 3 years later because of the group of guys I played with wanted to play. So I was like, all right. I kind of dipped my toes back in it. Luckily, I was older and smarter, so I didn't get as bad into it. But, you know, I still had fun. I still, every now and then, I'm like, man, I really want to go back and play some WoW.
Yes, Bert, we did start talking about Star Wars, but, you know, the conversation evolves into something else. But you're welcome to call if you've got a comment.
Yeah, Bert, we're cultured, so we can talk about multiple things. You
know, Star Wars. Yeah, we can have multiple conversations. It's okay.
Yeah.
It's good.
He wants you to keep it straight Star Wars.
Oh, does he?
Yeah.
What about? Does he want me to start going back to canon and stuff like that?
I don't know. Maybe he wants to get that rainbow lightsaber.
I have read quite a few of the Star Wars books that take place in between some of the movies and some of the side stories and things like that. What's the matter? Mm-hmm.
I don't know what's up with DJ over here.
He's bored.
Are you bored? What's the matter?
I have a theory, and that's that Art possibly fell asleep during the movie because he looks super tired.
Nope, love the movie. The movie's good.
Why are you kind of low energy today, guy?
I thought it was like I just had a Red Bull. I don't have low energy. I'm good.
No,
you're still down, man. No.
You're low energy, bro.
You're quiet.
I mean, don't start. Please don't start screaming into the mic. And if you do, give me a signal so I can try to get the level down.
I think it's coming. It's building up. Look.
He's about charging. To pick up.
He's charging.
Listen, man, I want to talk about this movie, but I can't talk about the movie.
Yeah, please
don't.
Kill
you guys.
I haven't seen it
yet. I want to tell you that there's some characters in there that I'm just like, what? I never thought I'd
know. Look, already one of the main spoilers has been leaked out, and I've already read it.
Which one was it?
I'm not that guy. I'm not going to say it. But I know, like, something dies and it's bad.
Nah.
Yeah. So somebody snuck that into a title on one of the posts on a forum board that I frequent. So you start.
Why would you go to the forum board?
No, it wasn't a Star Wars forum board.
Dummy.
I was looking for some news and stuff like that. And then all of a sudden you see like some government thing, you know, da 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 da.
CIA killed Chewbacca.
Yeah, well, that's kind of what it is. It was like, you know, they were talking about the Judge Moore thing. Listen, and the political. Man,
nobody really died in it. Nobody that you would expect.
See,
okay.
See, Chris is on a propane.
You hear what he said?
Yeah, nobody. I know.
Nobody you wouldn't expect. Wink, wink.
Yeah. Stop it.
Kylo Ren's actually good.
Stop. Just kidding. There's so many theories going on right now. About,
just kidding. Not
about
kidding.
How it happens with him and Rey and stuff like that. I mean,
they might have had sex.
Hey, oh, Bert. God. Bert, don't use the N-word.
Oh, what's he doing?
Yeah.
Bro.
He used the N-word.
Did he say negative Nancy?
No, he said, don't you dare, Nugs.
No, man, these are just theories you can read online.
Nugs is Chris's handle.
Yeah, that's my gamer. That's my gamer tag. It used to be Punk Nuggets, and I just...
What?
Yeah, it used to be Punk. There was a... I used to play in LAN parties. I used to play Quake a lot. And so we would have LAN parties.
So it's like local area network. It's just like you connect the computers
together. Basically, like all of us would have our PCs together in this room and we would all be playing against each other.
Yeah, it smells like...
It was before internet was really popular.
Smells like virgins.
No, it smells like virginity, Mountain Dew, Doritos, and neckbeard.
Yeah, but we used to go to LAN parties, so there'd be like 25, 30 people kind of together. And
what's up, dude?
And so I played Quake, and I always used to... I was pretty good at it. And one of the girls that were on one of the other teams, Anna... she became a good friend of ours, but I would kill her quite a lot because she was pretty predictable on how she would play. Because
you were trying to just off the girl?
No, she was predictable. That was the thing. She was.
Man, let me tell you something, dude. If you want to get your kill ratio up, man, you got to find yourself a girl and just beat her up. They're pretty predictable. You hit them once, they start running.
Chris
hit
like
good.
This. Chris is like, he beat her. He's like, sorry, sweetie, you got to go to the kitchen to make me a sandwich.
No, she would always try to hover around where the heavy weapon would spawn and shit like that. Oh, so she was pretty easy to...
And by heavy weapons, he means the experienced guys.
No.
So, but every time I would kill her, she started getting mad, and then one day she stood up. She started yelling at me, and she called me, you know.
She flipped the table?
Nah, she didn't do that. She called me a little punk, and then she kind of paused and then said Nugget. And then that name kind of stuck with everybody in the LAN party, so everybody just started calling me Punk Nugget. So then that was like 20 years ago, and then I've just kind of changed it down to Nugs. Yeah,
you've been modified, huh?
That's so funny. She called you a Punk Nugget.
Mm-hmm. You got dang punk.
Yeah, I've only had two real nick. Well, now I've got three, but I've only had two real nicknames growing up. And one was Tig. No, one was Tigger, and then the other one was Nugs.
Because he was so energetic and bouncy. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Dude, Tigger?
Tigger. That's actually what's tattooed on my arm up here is Tigger.
That's very Callahan.
You know, when you combine Tigger and Nugs, you know what you get?
What?
You know, that explains why he goes...
Tugger.
You thought you were going to say something else.
I got you on DirecTV for the Tugger.
That explains why he goes to Disney so much.
Oh, shit.
And now it's Teddy Bear. But really, the only one that calls me Teddy Bear is Bert. I mean, it's just shortened down to TB. Don't do it, TB.
Tuberculosis.
Yeah.
Right, he's contagious. Stay away from that man.
I'm a hugger, you know.
So. He's a hugger.
Teddy bear hugs.
So would it be Nugger?
No.
Oh, shit. Be careful.
That's too close. That's too close.
Hey, Siri, remember, when it's on red, you don't talk about it.
You are skating on thin ice, little lady.
That's a razor's edge right there.
He's got Nugs. Hugger and Tigger.
Yep. Yeah, okay, let's leave it at that. Don't say anything.
Guys, let's see what your combinations you come up with. Go and hit us up on our comment page there.
Yeah, keep it all to yourselves.
Dude, not all I know is that me and Wallow were at the movie theater at 9:45 this morning. We had a coffee. We had a donut.
Yo, how packed was that? I feel like it was
Wasn't that packed.
It wasn't.
And, but oh, he, picked, he, dude, he picked the top far left. I was like, pick the middle.
It's okay. We got our seat.
But at least it wasn't all your clothes.
Check it out. So we stopped at Dunkin' Donuts to get some coffee. And I'm like, what do you want? He's like, I just want a medium coffee. That's it.
No vanilla latte?
And
not a Dunkin'. It tastes too sweet.
That's
right.
So yeah. I order the, you know, the coffees and two donuts. I'm like, I know I want a donut. And when he sees me eating my donut, he's going to want one.
And he did, right?
And he did.
Of course.
Wait. Honestly, I know why art is low energy.
Why?
Last night during the fights, he was gone for a good 30 minutes to an hour.
I would go closer to an hour.
Yeah.
Him and the women's fight.
That drained all the energy out of him.
It did. It really did.
That's what it was.
It was not that long.
He's still recovering.
It's like he just lost all his life force.
Dude, that was an act of domestic terrorism there. That shit was bad.
He was dropping bombs over Baghdad.
Dude, that was
stomach
a war
was messed
crime.
Up, man. It was a situation.
Dude, when you left, it still smelled pretty bad.
It's pretty awesome. Okay, I didn't smell it. So.
To you. Yeah, because you left.
What are you talking about, man? This is Art of War, dude. He shits flowers.
I got to go.
Dude, he had a fart of war, man.
Oh, damn.
It may or may not have been a situation. But it was cleaned up at the end. So it was all good.
Cat litter thrown on the wall.
Probably threw it in the cat litter.
Right.
Oh, that'd be funny if you took a shit in the cat litter.
You could hold it.
Bro, it was
he's not, throwing the cat litter down the toilet.
I mean, it was not comfortable. That's all I gotta say.
You know why it's? You know how I know it was bad? Because he snapped me twice during this.
It did.
Wow.
It was a Christmas sweater with the shit emoji on it. I was like, this is so painful.
See, this is when you probably needed the squatty potty. It would have probably helped you out,
dude. Darling.
Nah, bro. This is what.
I don't think he had any issues with that.
Listen, I just had to sit, man. You can't force those things. You just gotta let it ride out. Handle business.
Let it ride.
You got a phone for a reason. Just start surfing.
Remember back in the day when you didn't have a phone, so you'd read the shampoo bottles and shit.
I never did that.
You had to watch out for spiders and bears.
Yeah, you had Frankie look out for you.
Listen, bro, man, spiders and bears are a legit threat. Okay.
No particular order.
You can't sleep on either one of those. Who lifts the lid before they squat down and they go to number two?
Always.
I do, because I found shit under there. I was like, one, I found a spider. One, I found a cockroach. I was like, either one, I wouldn't want anywhere near.
Imagine that cockroach tickling your ass while you're trying to
poop.
No.
La cucaracha in your culo. La cucaracha. I said, no. I was like, what are you doing in there? I killed him. I put him in the toilet, flushed it, and then I went to the bathroom.
Surprised he's still alive while you were taking care of business.
Oh, it didn't happen. We didn't have it last time. I'm talking about it's happening before, though. That's why
No, we thought you passed out, you know, in the bathroom.
No, bro. Fumes. I was just hanging out there, just like.
You're marinating.
I was like, this is the worst.
So this is what we're doing for the next hour.
That's
Well, the combination of the coffee, the pizza, and the flancocho.
Oh, yeah.
God, that was so good. I've never had that before.
I fucked up. I should have had some. I still had
Yeah, you had some time.
I had time to kill food.
Listen, bro, cheap. You didn't. It tasted really good, but it might have been an issue.
Hey, well, it didn't cause any issue on my end. So I mean, it was good for me.
Yeah, not like you, man. You, you know,
I didn't really eat much a whole lot this week, so I mean, maybe it was just like, you know,
or, lots of coffee. You're just trying to mark your territory, I understand.
Like, listen, man, see this bathroom? There's many bathrooms like this, but this one is mine.
How do we go from Star Wars to poop?
Because it happens.
You guys started talking about poop.
Thanks, Milena.
You guys started trying to bust my balls about being in the bathroom. I had to go, man.
That was all Miguelina.
No, I'm saying. I'm just trying to point out why
you guys jumped on that though. You look spiders and bears. Like, fuck yeah,
that was Chris.
Yeah, you two, both you guys.
I'm trying to point out why you're so low energy right now. That's all.
Oh yeah, that's what it was. Talking about how I'm low energy. I'm not low energy, man.
Yeah, you are.
I was hanging out and I'm observing, I'm watching, I'm listening, see, talking.
Now the Red Bull's finally kicking in because you're talking a little bit more.
No, it's fine. It's because you guys are engaging me. When you guys are going off, he's talking about him being called Little Nugget and Tigger Nugs. I don't know.
Tigger Nuts.
Yeah, Tigger Nuts. You know, Little Nugget, Tigger Nuts, whatever he wants to be called. I don't know. I'm just
I can't say that name at all because I know I'm a fuck up because I'm thinking really hard not
so
to.
So gonna fuck up.
So I'm not gonna say anything.
So like on Facebook, you use your white man's name, Mike, and then there were like Biggie and Miguelino.
My resume name is Mike.
That's my buddy Raul. His middle name is Mike, so he uses that for his resume.
Smart.
So like when he goes in there, and he's from the one with all the statues of penises.
What?
He's Peruvian.
Wait, statues of penises? What?
Yeah, in Peru, they have like all these wooden statues. They're all just like a bunch of phallic penises and stuff. Anyways, so like he was getting hired over at this job that I had a little bit of influence on. You know, they called me in. They're like, hey, what do you know about this guy, Mike? I was like, who's Mike? Like, he said he was in the Navy with you. And I was like, Raul? They're like, no, it said his name is Mike. I was like, his first name's Raul. And he was like, they're like, oh, they said it on here. I was like, oh, you know what it is? So he feels that if he put Raul as his name in there, Mike is his middle name. If he puts Raul as his name on the
first name?
Yeah, his first name on the thing, that he wouldn't get looked at twice. You know what I mean? Because they're like, oh, Raul, that doesn't sound. You know
Did
what
he
mean?
Get the job?
He got the job.
You know why, too, right? They're like, oh, shit, if we say no, we're going to look.
Because they asked me, they're like, is he a good worker? I was like, well, he was a good worker when I was in the Navy with him. He wasn't really that great at work. He was always late, but he was good with the patients, and when he did stuff, he was competent. So I was like, yeah, man, I give him a stamp. I was like, 10 years ago, 5 years ago, however long it was, I was like, he was good when I worked with him. I didn't throw him on the bus.
That's a good.
But he's still
mate.
There. They like him.
It's a good shipmate right there.
Yeah.
Took care Zulu.
Of him. I was like, listen, man, this is why they didn't do that. They're like, oh, well, we don't discriminate like that. I'm like, okay, well, we'll see if you hire him or not. You're welcome, buddy. I got you back, dog.
Yeah, and Art was right on the Peruvian statues of fertility.
He just looked up all the images.
So listen, he didn't have to look it up. He had that shit already.
He was like, you know what?
Downloaded.
Oh, yeah, history
he
down.
Penis
yeah.
statue? What?
Category down. There it is.
Yeah. He's going to buy one for the studio.
Penis, miscellaneous.
Penis.
Oh, I've already got statues like that. Y'all, I just haven't shown y'all this. I've got them right back here.
Oh, God. Here we go.
These were really
pulls out a big
statues.
Dildo.
No, actually.
They're little things.
My frogs. I've got little frogs. These were my grandfather. My grandfather, as I've talked about before, but my grandfather traveled the world. He was a merchant marine.
So he went to Peru?
He did. Actually, he did.
You got to see those little penis frogs.
So you've got, you know, the.
You got to raise it up. We can't see.
They look like, you know, normal frogs. And then when you turn them over, one's got a penis, one's got, you know, tits and a veg.
Show them on the camera.
Boom. Regular.
Frog.
Boom. Not regular. So these were just the only ones I got from when he died. I mean, because.
When you die, I want those.
Okay, I'll leave them to you.
In his will, it's like
no,
this.
That's what you said to him.
No. He went for the will reading, and he's like, all right, the penis and vaginal frog.
Those are mine.
Chris, little Chris, here you go.
There's, yeah. Well, I mean, he had, you know, there were also the ones where the guy that had the spear and all like that, and then whenever you undid the front, the wooden plank fell out, and then there was a little penis on a metal spring that they fashioned. So I mean, this was just the shit that he got from like Brazil and all of South America because he was down there a lot.
It's the women.
He says that some of the most beautiful women you will ever see was always down in South America.
You know what? Like, I've been all over the world and stuff, and I think France had some really beautiful women. They all had like really the ones I noticed were like all really black hair and like blue eyeballs. It was
and
crazy.
Hairy?
No, not hairy.
I like the Swedes.
That's the common misconception about all these European women. They're like, oh, they're all hairy. I'm like, I don't think they're hairy, dog.
Oh, wait. Define hairy, Art, and define how you found this out.
Well, you know, you go to the beaches. They're not proves like they are here.
Okay.
Just saying, it is what it is.
You've been to a nude beach?
Yeah, well, in Europe, yeah, it's not a big deal. Like, you go to a normal swim pool, like, most of them are nude anyways.
Were you nude as well?
May or may not have been, I'm just saying.
Check I'm just asking out. You a just question, saying. God.
Nah, man, I wasn't nude, but I was dragging.
I'm not asking you Star Wars.
You guys are trying to paint me in a corner here, I'm just saying.
I was making a ditch when I walked down the beach.
Just saying.
Sorry, Brandon, Art's already gone to the movies. He's not going to the movies with you.
Yeah, I'll go again. I'll go again, man, because I
get. Oh, well, there you go. You got a date.
Hey, I got a t-shirt for you, buddy. So,
what kind of t-shirt?
It's one from Peru. Nice.
With penises.
Nice.
Obviously. Yeah, fuck you too.
Is that what he wrote?
Yeah.
That's so fun. Hey, man. Hey, seriously, though, I need help putting up that fence, man. I need to borrow your truck and we go grab four panels, put that thing up real quick. Is that cool?
Yeah, well.
Like ASAP.
Check
like
it out. Discussing business.
Do that. Podcast. Like Monday. Right. Through Monday.
Monday?
Don't just we have, another
don't,
manic
don't
Monday.
Don't we have business on Monday?
Yeah, we got business Monday, but it'll be later Monday.
Oh, okay. Cool.
Just another
I don't have to teach Monday. Or anything at night, so we got time.
He knows the number. He can call Lenny if he wants.
Yeah. Poha.
Cool. So what happened to the topics today, Wallo? I didn't see an email.
This is what happened was we were at Star Wars, and I was like, yo, let's do this Star Wars thing. And he was like, yeah, fuck those topics, man. We'll just talk. Just talk. We figure it out. We just figure out. We'll start talking about random stuff. Peru.
Spoiler alert, you know.
Spoiler alert.
I did see in an article that somebody else came forward about Dustin Hoffman. I just didn't
know. Yeah, four. I saw four.
Four.
Four more.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought he was one more.
No, four more. And then also.
Wait.
Got a caller.
Yeah, that's Brandon. What's up, Brandon? What's up?
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, that died.
What's up?
No, there it is.
What's going on? Chris is trying to cut you off.
The movies with me, jackass.
Yeah, well, Wallow Beach to it, man.
Yeah.
You got to be up bright and early. Message me at 7 o'clock talking about, yo, dog, I got you a ticket. Listen up here, cocksucker. We're going at 9:40.
Damn, you just turned into Coco?
That's what he told me. And I said, okay, man.
Stay black, motherfucker.
I brushed my teeth, and he picked me up. I didn't even have to drive. He was like, I got you. And they bought me a donut. I couldn't resist.
And coffee.
And coffee. See, what you want, man?
You got Waylo sitting next to you. He's kind of like an Ewok.
Hey, not Waylo. Wallo.
Waylo.
God damn it.
Waylo.
I thought we were cool, man. And you're calling me Waylo?
It's funny. Frank Barker calls you Waylo. Yeah.
Yeah, but he's, you know, he's Australian, though.
Oh, Waylo.
I mean, that's how it's spelled.
Whatever.
We know
you guys watch any of the Noki Worlds?
No, man.
When was that?
Last night?
Yeah, I can't afford to go
back. Yesterday, today.
No. Anybody got in your stable that you're trying to promote?
Kaya won.
Oh, that's shocking.
Yeah,
I know.
What is he now? 12th time?
Yeah.
Not 27.
It sounds like you need to update your flyer, man. Hey, by the way, I'm going to that Kyle Terror seminar. Who else is going? Sherry, you're going.
Sunday.
Wally, you're going?
I got to wait till after Christmas, bro. I'm tight.
He's got to pay you after Christmas. Are you there?
That's cool.
Cool.
He's like, I don't give a fuck as long as I get my money.
Boy, there it is. You said, yes! I ain't even lying, man. I'm going to talk to a couple other people, too.
Yeah,
you need your fence fixed, my Art.
What's that? I need it ASAP, man. I need to grab four more panels. Apparently, the four panels that fell down were rotted anyways. I got posts already up. Just need some panels.
Are the panels bad, or is it just the postings that need to be replaced?
Well, I got new posts up, man. Just the panels. Panels are apparently bad, man. So, I mean, I think we can grab panels for like $35 each. We'll grab four of them pieces and shoot on out.
Yeah, you can do that.
Yeah.
Just let me know when you want to go pick them up. We can use the truck.
That'd be dope, man. You got a pneumatic nail gun or anything like that?
No, it's called a screw gun.
That's it. That's what I'm talking about. Yeah, use that. Sounds good. Perfect.
Yeah, you need to put them up with screws or they'll all just back out.
Yeah, that's perfect. Sounds good. You got it locked in. We're good.
Well, when you get done with the podcast today, give me a call.
All right. Sounds good, man. Hell yeah. Get that shit knocked out today, maybe.
Come over there and freaking pick your ass up.
That's my boy. Look at that. My guys took care of me. You guys are all great support, man. I love all you guys. This is good. I don't tell you enough.
You should have Sherry.
I only tell you guys like 10 times a day. I don't even think that's enough.
It's not.
It's not. What were you going to say, Brandon? I'm sorry.
But you should have everybody from the podcast come and do a fence party.
Yeah, let's do a fence party right after the podcast.
It's my dog.
Oh, I got a phone call?
Hey, hold on, let me. I got a
phone call. Miggy's like, listen, man. I don't.
Yeah, I'm not that kind of Hispanic to go.
Well, hey, check it out, man. They're Puerto Rican. They're not really Mexican. You know what I mean? They don't work that way. What's that? Hello?
We'll talk to you after a word from our sponsors.
Yeah, exactly. They're like, and lazy.com. Just kidding. They're not lazy.
All right, guys. Thank you, please.
All right, bro.
All right, buddy.
Lazy dog.
Chooses.
We're not lazy.
No, I'm just kidding.
We're just not Mexican. Just kidding.
Those are some hardworking people. Yeah. Tell you what, man.
Well, why don't you give John a call? He might be able to help you out.
No, John got fired last time. He's half Puerto Rican in the show.
Yeah, but it was the Mexican half that you fired.
It must have been, man. That's home training, maybe. Maybe that's home training. I don't know. I have to say. He was like, man,
how do you pick up leaves, bro?
He's like, I need some gloves. I was like, bro, I got you a rake. He's like, yeah, but to get into the bags. I was like, there's a bucket right there. Just scrape it into the bucket, take the bucket, put it in the bag. He filled the bag a quarter of the way full, dragged it out to the front. But not drag all of them out to the front. He made a line that started from the front to the middle of the front yard. So it was like a beeline. I was like, that trash people ain't going to come get that in the middle of the damn yard. And you didn't even fill the bags up, man. You wasted like 10 bags. But well, you fit all that in 5 bags.
You didn't lay it out all the way. Because what he probably did is fill it up the bucket with leaves, put the bucket of leaves in the bag, and then that was it for the bag.
Dude.
You didn't say you could put multiple buckets in the bag.
So bad. Poor John Green. I just don't know, man. I don't know. Yeah. But anyway, he got fired, so no, he can't do more work for me. The job should have took about 2 hours.
How long did it take?
I don't know. He quit. He's like, oh, I'm really, really thirsty.
But you still owe him $20, bro.
Yeah, he owes me. Anywho.
All right, well, I just pulled up something. I know we kind of talked about it earlier, but nobody kind of went around the horn about how they really felt about this. But okay.
What the shit? What happened?
Sorry, I'm just looking.
The cat?
Cat's doing something weird over there. Anyways, have you heard about the Gracie Black Belt calls Rickson a fraud for supporting a convicted child molester?
No, excuse me. It's Hickson, not Rickson.
Rickson?
Gracie
Black Belt. What's up,
Rickson? Yeah, he did call him Rickson. Sorry. Yeah.
Rickson. But, Hickson, so Hickson. Buddy. Yeah. Sorry, I was just reading it verbatim. But, he's got a second-degree black belt under him who was convicted of a child molestation.
Or a 15-year-old.
Was it recently or was it old?
No, it was old. It was oldish.
It surfaced because he was training with Hickson.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's so bad that even one of Brendan, what is it?
Culbreth?
No, Brendan Hetzler.
That's Brandon.
Who was a black belt under Crone and Hickson, actually said to that he, you know, he gave up his black belt with them.
Shit. What? Yeah. Well, I mean, it's true, though. You know, like, with all this, all they preach about what a black belt means, one of them is you don't molest kids, clearly.
And well, I mean, that shouldn't really just go for black belts.
For all humans.
That should go for
no. What's really weird is, you know, I've seen that in other.
Sorry.
I've seen that before, you know, where in a gym.
What's going on down there?
You didn't hear that?
No, what's going on? I can hear.
All that folding was just coming through.
Oh, my bad.
Sorry, see, guys. That's how you know you're low energy, man. I'm telling you, I hate to go back on this, but that poop was something else, man.
Man, you guys, okay, I'm out of here.
He's about to go poop some more.
Hey, that's mine.
I'm going to go make a coffee.
Make a poo-poo.
Are you going again? No, coffee's downstairs.
Yeah, let him get his coffee.
Coffee's
downstairs. He's actually going to the bathroom downstairs.
But he said he talked to Rickson and asked him about Hickson about it. And whenever Hickson wouldn't denounce the guy, he asked to be removed from the JJGF as I wanted to be no part of it.
I guess like, yeah, Jiu-Jitsu Gracie Federation probably or something.
Yep.
So what's his response as far as supporting the guy? Is he supporting him or is he just not?
He hasn't said anything. I don't think he hasn't addressed
it. The only one that said anything is the guy. His name is like David Arnk or something like that.
Yes.
He owns a couple schools apparently as well, which is crazier.
Yeah.
But apparently this guy has like a web page that says like the facts about whatever happened.
Yeah.
.com/truth.
Yeah. And then And then one of another black belt Hickson's, Henry Akins or Atkins, probably Akins, I think, commented on that same thread that the guy said this was slander. He's like, look, clearly your defense team wrote that webpage. And if you were truly, you know, if you weren't guilty, you would not accept the plea for that case because you accepted a plea. Because again, you know, like, you know, no one is ever fine being accused of child molestation and just lets it ride. No one does that.
Not with the ramifications that come after it, no.
Yeah, no one, like.
But yeah, so he took a plea deal. So he was actually convicted. When
did this happen? Was it like a
2015, I believe?
What did they say? Was it consensual? Is he saying it was?
No,
like,
they're
it
trying.
It can't
to,
be consensual.
I mean, no, I know. When but
they're trying to frame it to where the little girl she lied.
She lied about her age.
No, she lied about what happened.
Oh, what? Okay.
Yeah.
So they're trying to make it seem like saying stories
exactly,
and stuff like that.
Exactly. So, but even so, I mean, you can't have somebody with that clout over them.
Mm-mm. For example, how the Gracies treat jujitsu and stuff, that's something that, had it been anything else, like, for example, I hate to be that typical thing, but had it been like a drug case, for example, they would out that guy so fucking quick.
Yeah.
But with this would be, should be the same reaction. If not, obviously worse, in my opinion.
Yeah. It was 2013. He pleaded guilty to fondling a 15-year-old.
Dude, and again, he has one school.
So that was 4 years ago.
Yeah. So he hasn't really came out and said anything. Guy's still part of his federation.
Yep.
Still in schools. So it's going to be kind of interesting to see with the climate of today, you know, because the thing is he, you know, now granted, I'm, you know, like I said last time, I don't think, you know, you should completely go off of some of the he said, she said stuff always. But this went to court.
Yeah, dude.
Convicted. It's a done and deal.
If they couldn't prove his innocence, which is why they took a plea bargain, I guess, because they couldn't prove his innocence, then what the fuck?
Yeah. So, you know, that's.
There's no, yeah, you know, dude, that's something.
Unfortunately, it doesn't matter if you did or didn't, you are convicted of that. Yeah, I can't have you being a part of my federation
and
at all.
I've seen that a few times, unfortunately, in the jiu-jitsu community where there's been people that have been accused of that or that have actually been guilty of it, but these people get rid of those.
Yeah, they move them to – it's almost like the Catholic Church.
Yeah, exactly. They're just like, you're done.
Yeah.
You're not training
in my gym. You got to go to Brazil, buddy.
No, like, exactly. They're like, you're not training in my gym, and I'm going to make sure you never train in a gym again.
Yeah.
But Hickson's like, this guy run a school with Hickson's name on it.
Yeah, and he hasn't come out and said anything about it.
What was the outcome of his conviction? Did he do any time, or was it just like probation?
Probably got put like on a sex offender registry type of thing.
Okay. Hey, look, dudes, I got the OG gangster.
Hey, that was mine.
Nice. I only use that one for special occasions.
Bad trigger control.
You're bad flagging control. All of us.
More like Wallow.
And me. And you. And me.
I can't.
Look at Chris in the zone reading this.
Yeah, so, he's looking
to find out. So check this out. So how about that net neutrality, though?
What about it?
Repealed.
Was it repealed?
Yeah. Yep.
Really?
3-2.
Don't choke on it, bro.
It's like Thursday.
Are you sick, bro?
Yeah. When did they repeal it?
I think it was Thursday.
A bunch of states were like talking about suing them and stuff.
Yeah, right? Yeah, right now they're trying to fight that because, right now if they want, they're going to try to find ways to fuck us.
That's okay. I'll just not have any internet. Fuck it.
Yeah, bro.
That's how it'll have to be.
Listen, I grew up without the internet, so I'll be fine without it, even though I'm so, you know, I'm on it so much. I don't need it. I really don't.
If I get
rid of it, that's going to kill e-commerce. That's going to kill.
Yeah, that's true.
The porn industry.
It'll kill your Bitcoin. Gonna kill.
No.
Amazon.
I'll still get my money back.
I order a lot of stuff on Amazon, so. So if Comcast doesn't want me to order on Amazon, I guess I won't be ordering on Amazon.
Yeah, man, that's the weird thing about it. Like, you know, people are arguing, saying that the. Because what it was too with net neutrality, the internet was deemed like a utility. And people are trying to say, oh no, the government doesn't need to do that.
A small finger? What? Yes.
I was trying to read something on the net neutrality to get the gist of it.
You know, it's weird to go to Pornhub for your news.
Yeah, that's not
I'm just reading the articles.
I was.
I swear.
I don't like the pictures. I just like the articles.
I don't like videos at all.
I just like the acting.
So anyway, going back to net neutrality.
Yeah, so like...
I'm going to make a little noise here. You guys keep going.
All right, go ahead.
The argument for net neutrality is saying that...
Let's crash up. It's like, did I win something?
He's trying to see how many more Bitcoins he can buy, guys.
Guys, I just want you all to know that I'm a winner.
$2.
You're a winner, all right.
A wiener.
What did you win?
It is $2.
Score?
Winning number six. Six. $2.
All right.
We had $2.
Congratulations. At least someone won.
Anyway.
Put that towards the podcast.
Woo!
Back to net neutrality.
Yeah, so the argument is people are saying that the government shouldn't deem it like a utility. Which is
why is the government involved? Isn't the FCC an independent agency?
Federal Communications.
Yeah, no, that's Council. A government. That's a government agency.
It's still controlled the government.
I thought that they said that it was an independent agency and it had nothing to do with it.
That's like saying the CIA is an independent agency.
Even though they operate like it with their clandestine operations.
Well, it's still under the government umbrella.
Okay, but
same with the FCC. The FCC may be an independent entity, but it operates under the umbrella of the government.
Yeah, we pay for it.
Carry on.
It is funded by tax dollars.
Yep. So we pay for them to make decisions to make our lives more expensive.
We're paying them to fuck us?
Yes.
Okay, well, exactly. That's every politician, really. I mean, come on.
Yeah. So anyways, back to net neutrality. So the argument for repealing it is there needs to be less government regulation in the industry and that it'll, apparently create better service because they can apparently pay people more or something.
No, that's just
the bullshit argument.
So the fat pockets get fatter.
Yeah, exactly. Because I'm totally going to want to pay just to use fucking Facebook, which is a free service.
Well, they're probably trying to hope they're going for the competitive route where if Comcast is going to do this and this, then that means, AT&T is going to get you to come over because they're not going to do this and this, which will create competition.
I have an inside source. And, his name.
Yeah, don't really.
Rhymes.
Don't
with Trump?
No.
Dump.
He's a friend of ours.
Yeah.
Okay. He's an inside source. I can't reveal too much.
Don't reveal too much.
But he said that his company, Xfinity.
Yeah.
They said they're gonna still follow net neutrality rules.
Bullshit.
No, exactly. That's what people are saying.
Bullshit.
And what's interesting too is the fact that Disney managed to purchase Fox or 21st Century Fox or 20th Century Fox. Yeah. So it's really interesting to see what the fuck's gonna happen now because Disney's gonna take over. They're gonna have a share of Hulu now. They're going to own most of these major Fox channels.
Well, Disney's already shaping up to – they're going to have their own streaming service.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then so they also get more of the Marvel stuff now. So you
They bring all the things back. Basically, all the Marvel lines are brought back under one roof.
Yep. And then on top of that, the only thing that Fox is really keeping is FS1, FS2, Fox News. And I think maybe one more thing. Other than that, Disney's pretty much getting the rest of it.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Yeah.
As long as they don't screw up Deadpool 2.
As long as they just bring back King of the Hill, I don't care.
And that's never coming back.
They talked about that a few months ago.
Seriously?
Yeah. Mike Judge is bringing it up. But what sucks is some of the people that voice it are dead.
Yeah.
God damn it.
You know, Tom Petty. What did I say about
Dancing with Lady Bird?
Tom Petty was on there. He was the voice of Lucky Kleinschmidt. And they created the character of Lucky to make fun of Tom Petty.
And he voiced it.
And he voiced it. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. Boomhauer is still my favorite. That's my hero.
I love me some Boomhauer. Hey, man, what kind of fucked up, man? I didn't know how to understand that guy until I moved to Florida, man. So I listened to these motherfuckers talk down here. I understand that.
Yeah, it all makes sense.
Yep.
Well, they try to bring Beavis and Butthead back. But that didn't quite work out.
It is created by Mike Judge, also created King of the Hill in Office Space.
They brought back Beavis and Butthead for 2 seconds. People were like, it's drawn so horribly.
Well, no, because the thing is, too, they didn't make, they try to make it modernish, I guess.
Yeah.
It's if you think about it, who's the network that owns MTV? Is it Viacom? I think so.
I think so.
Because Viacom also owns Comedy Central. They have Tosh.0. Then MTV has their version, which is Ridiculousness with Rob Dyrdek.
Yeah.
It's a really shitty show, man. Yeah, I hate to say it. Because they have Rob Dyrdek and some chick named Chanel West Coast. She laughs to every fucking thing.
Oh, my God.
It's fucking
so bad.
Torture. She's like,
ha, 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 ha. You're so funny, Rob.
Did y'all see the video of Chanel West Coast? With Charlamagne the God? What?
On TMZ?
No, what's up?
Oh, God, what happened?
Oh, apparently she went to a club in West Hollywood. And she was there with seven of her girlfriends or whatever. Mm-hmm. And the guy at the door is like, nah. You gotta wait in line and shit. Hey, because she was just trying to get in the club.
Do you know who I am?
Exactly.
I thought she did this.
she pulled back card. She's like, do you know who I am? Blah, blah, blah. started going off, and TMC caught the whole thing on video.
Nice.
Yeah. It's like, you know what? Listen, your 15 minutes of fame were up like 10 years ago.
You guys want to hear something kind of messed up?
How is she even famous?
I don't know.
I love messed up stuff.
You guys ready?
Yes.
Do you remember when Ashton Kutcher used to have this show called Punk'd?
Yeah.
Well, there's this girl from my hometown of Alaska. Her name is Jewel. And they punked her, and she
is that the one that sued?
She pulled that. Do you know who I am? All that kind of stuff. I was like, I can't like you anymore.
Oh,
it went to your head. You're a folk singer from Alaska.
Wait, it went to her head that she got punked?
No. She's like, you know the singer? Who I am, and started going off on this guy because they're fucking with her. She's like, you know who I am? I was like, oh.
I would have never figured. Your
attitude. I would have never either.
Because I liked her.
I was like, Jewel, no. What are you doing? And then,
are you disappointed?
I was disappointed.
Have you listened to her music ever since?
So close to having a good one.
No.
What the fuck? What is he dying over there for?
Because Miggy's right here just exploded. Because we set our levels on our headphones for low T art, and then Art went and got coffee and came back up and became
regular Art
became Verdum up in here and just blasted his ear.
What, right now?
Yeah, right now. You came on strong. You came on strong. But hey, it's good to have you back on the podcast, buddy. We like that.
Guys, I'm going to talk to you real quick. I got to be serious.
Hold on, let me pull this off a little bit more just in case he does bring one of those bouts of.
I'm going to be very serious. I want you guys to listen up real close.
Okay. All right. He's about to yell or something.
Fuck y'all. I'm just going to go back to sleep over here.
Okay. You know.
So anyway, so your Viacom thing, it's a BET, CMT, Comedy Central logo, MTV, MTV Classic, MTVU, MTV2.
Oh, yeah. You said VH1, right?
Yeah, we'll get there. Yeah, so Nick at Night, Nick Jr., yep. Nickelodeon, Spike, Teen Nick. I didn't even know there was a Teen Nick.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
TV
yeah.
Land and VH1.
Speaking of Spike, it's becoming Paramount.
What I mean?
They're getting rid of Spike.
Yeah.
Remember how you did TNA?
Well, Viacom owns Spike. Paramount Animation, and Paramount Home Media Distribution.
Spike is becoming Paramount now. And what's weird, though, is in order like to promote the channel change, they're having like the official account of Spike saying, hey, guys, if you're going to miss Spike or if you want to stop this change, comment on this thread. And then people are like, Spike fucking sucks because all you guys is play cops now. And then the Paramount account's like, yeah, you're totally right. And then the Spike account's like, oh, that's so fucked up. They're just fucking around with people just to
trolling.
Promote the channel.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Ever since Live PD came out, I don't watch.
Oh, man, that show is so.
I like trolling one person.
At a time?
No, just one person.
Just one person.
Oh.
Yeah. Because it's so fun.
It is.
You know, I just push a button.
Oh, they make it easy, though.
Yeah.
They do. They bite every time. So every time every you time. Cast, they bite. They just don't get it, man. Jesus.
I love him.
Every time I see you cast that line, I'm going, oh, let's see if it and he bites. It's a new record. 15 seconds after that was posted. He's reeling them in.
It's fun.
It is. I love that guy.
Yeah.
Turn five.
Are we having him on soon?
Yes. He's got a fight coming up soon. So he.
No, say it right.
I'm sorry. He's got a fight.
There you go. Up
I soon. Want him to spell that for us when he gets here. I just want him to like spell it out.
AF.
He doesn't have to because we know how to spell it.
AF. A.
No, but I want to see how he's spelling it.
F A I.
Oh, sorry.
G H T.
Because I've seen this spelling before on a lot of shit. And I've had to kind of reread and go.
I know what you mean. You know?
You know, I can't wait.
It's like not everything is Twitter, bro. You don't have a character a cap. Limit. Yeah, character limit.
Oh, you know that they up the character.
Yeah, I think 280. It's 280.
Yeah.
So it's like a text message and a half now.
Yeah. Well, there used to be other things like you had Twit Longer and stuff like that where you could, you know, instead of the 140, you could drag it out longer.
Well, it was.
Did he say Twit Longer?
Yeah, that was one of the apps.
Twit extension.
Twit Longer.
He's like, hey, everyone in Callahan, check this out. My tweets are long.
I don't Twitter.
I know.
I don't even.
I just put TLDR at the bottom of everything I don't want to read.
Yep, too long.
TLDR.
If you're too like, it's one sentence. TLDR. I can't.
I used it a while back.
Can't even.
I mean, I still do it every once in a while to communicate with some people.
I never got into
advertise
it.
The podcast.
I only do it to harass
I'm just like, oh, sorry, I didn't see the message. But like, I saw the icon that said that she saw the message. I'm like,
I don't know why. I got, you know, I do Facebook and I do Instagram.
You're right, I lied.
Sorry. I check y'all on Snapchat every now and then, but very rarely do I ever snap anything.
By the way, guys, we were supposed to have a guest today, and we apologize that the guest for some reason fell through. And we are not having Anna Dempster on the podcast today. If that's what you were tuning in for. Just to let you all know.
And everybody stopped listening.
Yeah. One viewer.
They stopped listening when you weren't talking about Star Wars, when you posted you were talking about Star Wars.
I believe that too.
Whatever. Way to get the nerd
rage. They're like, nice clickbait, bro.
Hey, that's all right. Maybe they'll engage us now on the Facebook page with their anger.
So let's start talking bad about Star Wars. You know, Star Trek is so much better anyway.
Have you seen the shit storm that's the new Star Trek that's on, I think it's NBC?
What are you talking about, thing? Fox? No. Because Seth MacFarlane has like a shitty
That's a total Star Trek. That's
the Orville thing?
The Orville thing. Yeah,
there you go, that's it.
That's a spoof thing. But no, they actually came out with a new Star Trek series. But
say that again?
Star Trek series.
Star Trek.
Deep Space Hole.
No, that wasn't a good one.
Damn, he told you.
No, the porn.
I know.
But I guess it's behind, it's to watch it, you got to be part of their streaming service.
Oh, yeah.
And so it's behind a paywall. And a lot of people are like, I'm not paying just to
watch this one
shit. Yeah, just to watch this one thing.
Nice try, hey, NBC.
Yeah, I've never been a Star Trek fan, so.
It's all right.
They can suck it.
The Next Generation was, you know, it was cool. Only because it ran for like 15 years. I mean, you've got 1,000 episodes. It's one of those shows where it's good. I stick it down on Netflix, like on Sundays or Saturdays when there's nothing going on in the house, and just let it play.
1,000 episodes?
It's got quite a few. I don't think it's got a full 1,000.
I did not know that.
It went for a long time.
Yeah, sorry.
Long time.
I'd rather watch Dukes of Hazzard or Miami Vice.
Oh, now Miami Vice would be good. I could do that. Did you see the movie, the new movie one that they did years ago?
Yeah, with Colin Farrell and Jamie Foxx.
Yeah. I'm not sure how I felt about that.
Oh, speaking of like older stuff, have you guys seen that Lethal Weapon TV series that Fox
had? I have not. No, I refuse. No.
Is it?
Lethal Weapon holds a special place in my heart. I enjoyed those.
I watched the first episode and I'm like, no, not interested. Thank you.
See, now I know not to watch it.
My newest crusade is still trying to, people are still trying to say that Die Hard is not a Christmas movie.
And it is a Christmas movie.
It is. And Die Hard 2 is a Christmas. Every Die Hard is a Christmas movie.
Well, where was 3? No, 3 was
Nakatomi Plaza.
No, Die Hard with a Vengeance was not.
Really?
It was in the summer.
Okay, well then Die Hard 2 was definitely still a Christmas movie, I think. So I think 1 and 2 are Christmas movies.
Yeah, 3,
4. Art, what do you think?
It's a Christmas movie.
Okay.
He's checking on his Bitcoin. Yeah, how are we doing? Are we up? Are we down? What?
We're up, brother.
It was up almost $200 just in a day.
Jesus Christ. I'm making some fucking money for real.
Nice.
Let's see here. Bloop. $19,437 for 1 Bitcoin.
Oof.
God, it is on a man. That curve scares me.
So what about the fight last night with Ricardo Lamas? And the guy from Alpha Male, I forgot his name.
I don't even remember that fight.
I thought Ricardo Lamas died in the
game. He did. I think he died. You gotta go check on that dude.
Oh, man. That's that one knockout.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That was nasty.
Where DC had him do the replay where it showed him how many times his head bounced off the mat. Yeah. 3 times, count it.
What? What? He didn't laugh.
Oh, man. That was a good fight. What was the other one? I don't know. The main event? Main event kind of.
It was meh.
Lawler did good, like, what, 1 and 2?
Yeah,
then he took that leg kick in 3, and then it just kind of trailed off. You could see afterwards, he knew. He's like, man, fuck, I didn't win this. Not even close.
You see when Dos Anjos went to shake his hand, he's like,
yeah, whatever, bro.
Hey, man, I like how the ref already raised Dos Anjos' hand before he made the announcement.
Little early, Eve Levine. Mm-hmm. Little early. Man, your Bitcoin's doing good.
I don't even have to check it. People check it for me.
I've just got the tracker up, so I'm just looking at it.
Also, want to send a shout out to our boys, Lane Peterson and Steven Costa,
who competed
last night in the River City Pro. Unfortunately, they didn't win, but it's okay.
You win some, you lose some.
Yeah, still good showing.
Experience too, man.
Yeah.
Dude, I'm mad proud of you guys. I mean, I watched you. You guys had really, really high level competition. You know what I mean? I know. I was actually surprised I didn't see more movement in Kozlo's match. That guy must have been really good because I don't ever see Kozlo get caught like that. He's so good, you know. So that was tight. And
yeah.
Lane, he went and gave it a good go. I think he was going against a really powerful brown belt, and He ended up getting caught in a heel hook. He was trying to go for honey stick, but he ended up getting his inside heel hook. I want to say it was. And he even tried to hold out just a little bit, man. Maybe a little bit too long. I don't know. He said that he was able to tap before any real damage. So I'm super happy that he's okay. And I can't wait to see those guys back in Jacksonville.
But also sending a shout out to Elijah Lane Carlton, who Sean Applegate spoke about in episode 26. And he won the whole thing yesterday at the River City Pro.
$1,600.
So congratulations to him for winning the tournament. Good showing, I guess. You know.
It's good to see B-Max Jim again. Always like seeing B-Max Jim.
You love just that like tiki hut.
I like his tiki hut.
Why don't you just build a tiki hut by your pool?
I want to. Man, you know what? That's a damn good idea, Wallo.
Build a mini tiki hut in that corner.
Well, no, that corner's going to be what I'm going to do the fire pit. So maybe I'll do
it. Right here, no, in this room. Build a mini tiki hut.
I have to do it over here. It's better.
There you go. Just do that.
Yeah, behind the camera. But no, I'm trying to get a fire thing set up because I want to have a fire around the house before this winter ends. So it's actually one of the first projects.
You got time,
why don't you bring your camper? You have plenty of plenty of fire. No.
No.
Okay.
No.
That's
no.
Cool, dude. No.
Fine.
Fuck you guys. No fun. But yeah, I want to have a little fire, a little cookout kind of thing around the house in the winter.
You should have done a cookout today. Because, you know, we can finish up here soon and throw some steaks or something in the grill.
Steaks.
That'd be kind of cool. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, maybe we'll do that one day. Sounds like a good plan.
Sounds like it's not going to happen today. So.
Oh, hell no.
It don't matter.
he's like,
I'm not going back to Costco today.
No, he's like this, man. You insulted my camper. You can get the fuck out of my house.
I'll cook you some chicken, extra rare.
No, I'll pass on. Thanks.
Some fajita chickens.
That's what you were tuning in. Just to let you all
know. What are we going? Inception?
Podcast. Yeah.
Podcast in a podcast?
Yeah, I wanted to read the comments. Sorry.
It's okay.
Because Wallo doesn't call out comments and he doesn't like, you know.
Well, I can't see him all the time because they'll pop in onto the phone and whatever, okay. And they leave.
So I got you. Never mind. I'm
sorry. They don't stay there.
Yeah, I just wanted to give a little shout out. It's like, hey, you know, I'll have a chance.
Sorry, man.
It's cool.
You can turn the volume down and read the comments.
No, it's coming. It's too late now.
You've hurt his feelings.
Right? Yeah, he only got caught.
All right. Well,
I was trying to be slick.
Well, guys, before we go, do you guys have anything else you guys want to add?
Check out the podcast beforehand with Zach. It was really good.
That was really fun, yeah.
That's a fun.
That was a fun podcast.
It was.
Yeah, so, man. Before we go then, let's give a shout out to our official sponsor.
Lean Impact Nutrition. Black Hive Tattoo. If you don't know, now you know.
Ninja.
Anybody else? Mickey, you got anything else? Sherry?
Nope.
Producer Chris, any other nerding out stuff that you want
to
add?
Nah, man. I think we'll have to get Art a couple coffees in, and then we'll have, see if we can't try to schedule Chris to come back on a podcast, and then we'll just go complete nerd out.
Then you will have to give Art some cups of coffee because I'll just be like that right now.
Yeah, no, we'll get him a cup.
No, man. Every time I'm going to go talk, you guys are like, oh, you're chilling out. Look, fuck you guys. Then. I ain't going to say shit.
Aw, you all heard.
You guys talk enough for me. It's good. Talk.
You heard these feelings, guys.
Oh, okay. Look, man. I drew pictures. This is what
sorry.
I did.
See I can't that? Hear you because my ears are bleeding.
What? See that? Complaining. All those complaints.
Fuck man. You, Miggy.
I'm just doing work.
Well, sorry that I have brain chunks coming out of my ears right now.
All right, guys. Well, thank you for your support. We really appreciate it. And, I don't know if we're going to be trying to do maybe two a week, or should we just stick to one?
We'll figure it out.
If we have a special occasion like Friday, we definitely should hit.
Yeah, we'll figure some stuff out.
All right.
Because that was really cool.
We might have some things to do Fridays. So we'll see next upcoming future, but we'll see.
Well, in between time, and in the meantime, we'll catch you next week. Peace.
It's big pimpin', baby. It's big pimpin', spinach. You feel me? Why? Thug 'em, fuck 'em, love 'em, leave 'em, 'cause I don't fucking need 'em. Take 'em out the hood, keep 'em looking.
good, but I don't fucking feed them. First time they fuss, I'm breathing. Talking about what's the reasons. I'm a pimpin' every sense of the word, bitch. Better trust and believe them. In the cut where I keep them. Till I need a nut, till I need to be the gust in it. Beep beep, then I'm picking them up. Let them play with the dick in the truck. Many chicks wanna put chicken fists and cup. Divorce them and split his bucks. Just because you got good head, I'ma break bread so you can be living it up. Shit, I pass with nothing. Y'all be fronting. Me give my heart to a woman. Not for nothing. Never happen. I'll be forever macking. Hard coded assassins. I got no passion. I got no patience. And I hate waiting. Don't get your ass in and let's ride.
Coming straight about the black barrio. Make some meal upon for sorry ho. Now sit back and be my scenario. Oof, my bad, that's my scenario. No, I can't fuck a scary hoe. Now every time, every place, everywhere we go, hoes stop pointing and say, there he go. Now these motherfuckers know we carry more heat than a little bit. We don't pull it out over little shit. And if you catch a lick when I spit, then it won't be a little hit. Go read a book, you illiterate son of a bitch, and step up your vocab. Don't be surprised if your hoes there. Hard with me and you see it's coming down on your slab. Living ghetto fabulous, so mad, you just can't take it. But nigga, if you hate now, then you wait while I get your bitch butt naked. Just break it. You gotta play like you way wet with two pairs of clothes on. Now get your ass to the back as I pass to the track. Timberland, let me spit my pros on. Post it up in the pro zone. That's the track that we breaking these hoes on. Hate the track that we flows on. But when shit get hot, then the glass start popping like ozone. We keep hoes drunk like Trigger Man. But really don't get no bigger, man. Don't trip, let's slip. Getting throwed on the flip, getting blow with the motherfucking Jigga Man. We be big pimping, spinning cheese. We be big pimping on BLADs. We be big pimping down in PAT. It's just that Jigga Man. Pimp C and B-U-N-B. Cause we be big pimping, spinning cheese. And we be big pimping on BLADs. Cause we be big pimping in PAT. It's just that Jigga Man. Pimp C and B-U-N-B. Nigga.
Smoking out. Up, keep it lean up in my cup. All my car got leather and wood in my hood. We call it buff. Everybody wanna ball. Holler at brawls at the mall. You be up, watch them fall. Nigga, I can't fuck with y'all. If I wasn't rapping, baby, I would still be riding Mercedes. Coming down and sipping daily. No records tell why they pay me. Now what y'all know about them Texas boys? Coming down to candy toys. Smoking weed and talking noise.